Microsoft Dynamics 365, Business Central Telemetry, creating custom queries in Kusto. Business Central emits telemetry data for various activities and operations on tenants and extensions. Monitoring telemetry gives you insight into activities and the health of your tenants, so you can diagnose problems and analyze operations that affect performance. This video shows how to query an Azure Applications Insights resource using the Kusto Query Language, or KQL. We'll use the Logs pane in the Azure Application Insights portal to run KQL queries, learn about the event IDs in Business Central Telemetry, and build a sample KQL query to learn the basics of the Kusto Query Language. Prerequisites for this video are to have enabled telemetry on one or more Business Central environments or extensions and have access to the Azure Applications Insights resource that stores the data. Let's start in the Azure Application Insights portal on the Logs page. On the Overview page, we'll choose Logs. If this is the first time we open the Logs page, we can click Get Started to get the KQL editor. We can also check out the resources for learning about the Kusto query language. The Logs page has several sections. On the left, we have an overview of the tables in Azure Application Insights. Currently, the Business Central environment logs data only to the Traces and Page Views tables. We can have multiple queries open at the same time. Right now, we only have one tab open, but we can click the plus icon to open a new query tab. To the right is an area where we can type KQL, and when we click Run, the query is run and the results show below the query. Let's try a simple example. A Kusto query always starts with a data source. We'll use the Traces table. If you know SQL, this is what you would put in the From clause of the query. When writing a KQL query, it's a good practice to limit the number of rows while experimenting with the query. For now, we'll use the Take clause to just get the first 10 rows. In SQL, this is like having a top 10 in the Select part of the query. Let's run the query. In the results, the first column is a timestamp of when the signal was emitted from Business Central. We can either filter data using the Time Range button or set a filter in the query. We'll do the latter. Similar to the Where clause in SQL, we can define filters on the data in KQL using the Where keyword. Let's type pipe symbol where timestamp is greater than ago1d on a new line after the traces line, and then click Run. Here we're asking Azure Application Insights to only return results that were emitted since yesterday. We can use a scroll bar if the data in the results set contains more columns than can fit on our screen. We can also click on the caret icon to the left of the row to explore the data in a vertical view. Often, we'll only need a few columns from the table. In SQL, we would specify those columns in the Select clause of the query. In relational algebra, which is the foundation of SQL, this is called a projection. Therefore, the equivalent keyword in KQL is called project. Let's add a project clause in our query. On a new line after the where clause, we'll type pipe symbol, project timestamp, comma, operation, underscore ID, comma, message, comma, custom dimensions, and then click run to generate the results. The operation ID column holds an identifier that is the same for all signals emitted by a session. The name of the column is defined by Application Insights, but we might want to rename it in our query. We can use the project rename operator to do that. So we'll type pipe symbol project-rename session underscore ID equals operation underscore ID on a new line after the project timestamp line and see that the column is now called session underscore ID. In SQL, we would use the as keyword to make an alias for our column name. In this demo, we'll ignore the details in the custom dimensions column. So we'll project this away using the project away operator. We'll type pipe symbol, project-away, custom dimensions on a new line after the project rename line, and click run to see the results. Finally, we'll order the results by session and timestamp to get an overview of what happened in the different sessions in the time frame we specified. We'll type pipe symbol, order by session underscore ID, comma, timestamp, ask on a new line just before the take line, and click run. Note that we can do something similar in SQL, but we cannot use aliases. In KQL, we build up the query by adding operators separated by the pipe symbol, like beads on a string. The order in which operators run is always linear, and one operation at a time. This contrasts with SQL, where the different parts of a query are not run in the order in which they're written. In SQL, the from clause is run before the select clause. Now we can save the query. We'll give it a name, leave the default selections in the Save As and Save To fields, and then click Save. We can click the Query Explorer icon to find our saved queries. Let's write a query that tells us what kind of signal is present in our telemetry resource. We'll click the plus icon to start a new query that uses the extend, distinct, and order by operators. We use the extend operator to create a new column called event ID and the distinct operator to only get distinct values. The example also illustrates how we can query the columns in the custom dimensions column. The custom dimensions is a JSON data structure that holds different columns for different event IDs. So what are these event IDs? We can find the answer by searching for an ID in the Business Central documentation. We'll copy the RT0006 event ID, open the documentation in a browser, and then paste the ID in the filter by title field. We'll choose search for RT0006 in all documentation. On the Telemetry Event IDs in Application Insights page, we can find the RT0006 ID and read the description. Let's try a sample query that uses this event ID. We'll go to the Business Central Telemetry Samples repository on GitHub by typing aka.ms/bctelemetrysamples, then choose KQL, Queries, Raw Data, and finally, reports.kql. Now we'll copy the first query and paste it in the query editor in Application Insights. In this query, we can see that a few more KQL constructs would be useful. The first line starts with ……. This is how to write single line comments in KQL. Here we need to use ### to test for equality. This where clause also shows how we can do and or in a filter predicate. There are also a lot of extend clauses in the query. Each of these takes a member of the custom dimensions and makes it a column. The Samples GitHub repository has sample queries like this for all event IDs, so that we don't have to write all of these extend clauses. We'll use a sample query to answer the question, what are the top 5 most popular reports ranked by popularity? The first thing we'll do is edit the query to remove all unneeded columns. This is important for readability and performance. The query could look like this. Now we'll add a summarize operator to count by report name, and then click Run. We can also transform data in the project operator by using toString. We need to do this conversion if we want to use a column from the custom dimensions JSON structure. The summarize operator in KQL can work like a group by clause in SQL. Now we'll add an order by clause. Application Insights will automatically name the new count column. If we want to control this name, we can do that directly in the summarize clause. Finally, we'll add a take operator to only get the top 5 most popular reports. And that's it. To learn more about how to query telemetry in Azure Application Insights with KQL, visit aka.ms/bctelemetrysamples. You'll find links to sample KQL queries and learning resources for getting started with KQL. If you're interested in Business Central and telemetry, there are several other videos available on this playlist. There's one that shows how to analyze performance using a Power BI report, one about triaging errors using a Power BI report, and one about troubleshooting using Jupyter Notebook guides. Thanks for watching. Microsoft logo.